Newton's rings is the best application for thin films, interference in thin films. The experimental arrangement consisting of a monochromatic source of light S and a convex lens, glass plate, a plano convex lens and a telescope. Now coming to the experimental arrangement, consider a monochromatic source of light and allow the monochromatic source of light to fall on a convex lens L. From the convex lens, the light rays will become parallel and falls on a glass plate G inclined at 45 degrees. So from the glass plate G, the light rays will bend with 90 degrees and falls normally on a plano convex lens, which is kept on a glass plate P, since L. Now, so whenever the light rays are reflecting and interfering, then on the telescope, on the top of the glass plate G, we have a telescope, and through the telescope, if you observe, you will get a rings pattern like that. So why we are getting that rings pattern is just because of, take this lens L and kept on a glass plate P. So whenever light is incidenting on this one, since it is incidenting normally, that means angle of incidence I is 0, automatically angle of refraction are also 0. So now, since it will go angle of refraction here. Now, there is a formation of thin film in between bottom of the plano convex lens and top of the glass plate. So this is the region where it is filled by air of refractive index mu. Now, at the top of the thin film, some part of light ray will reflect and some part light ray will refract. And again, from the bottom of the thin film, the light ray will reflect and moves outside, since the light ray 1 and 2 are in a position to get superimposed. So due to that, if the path difference between the two light rays is n lambda, then you will get a dark fringe, bright fringe, and if it is n plus 1 by 2 lambda, we will get a dark fringe. So if you consider the path, or already we calculated the path difference between the two light rays which are reflecting from a thin film. So the path difference between the two light rays which are reflecting from a thin film is 2 mu t cos r plus r minus lambda by 2, where mu is the refractive index of the thin film, t is the thickness of the thin film, r is the angle of refraction, which is 0, and lambda by 2 is the wavelength that we are using. And now, for this particular Newton's rings experiment, the thin film is formed by air, that's why mu is equals to 1. So refractive index of air is 1. And angle of refraction r also 0, because this is a normal incidence. Since light rays are incidenting on a plano convex lens normally, so whenever light rays are incidenting like this, the same will reflect back and both get superimposed, and you are getting alternative bright and dark rings. Why the center of Newton's rings is dark and reflected case, that we are going to see now. Now the path difference will become 2 mu is 1 t cos r is 0 degrees plus r minus lambda by 2. So now your path difference will become 2t plus r minus lambda by 2. This is the path difference between the two light rays which are reflecting from the thin film in Newton's rings experiment. So at the center, the thickness of air film is 0. At this position, the thickness of air film is 0, and here you can have some t. But at center, the thickness of the air film is 0. That's why your path reference now will become 2 of 0 plus r minus lambda by 2, and path difference is equals to lambda by 2. So if path difference is lambda by 2, one can have a dark fringe. That's why the center of Newton's rings experiment, the center of this one in reflected case, not in transmitted case, in reflected case is a dark one. And after that, we are having a bright and alternative bright and dark rings. Why we are getting alternative bright and dark rings is, since suppose at this particular distance, if the two light rays are superimposing, and their path difference is n lambda, in this position you can see white fringe. Suppose the same will happen in this position also. So the same will happen throughout the lens. And after that, if you see through the telescope, one can have alternative right and dark fringes. And why? If you move from center to the far away, all the rings will come closer to each other. And why we are going to see now. So up to here, the center of Newton's rings is a dark one. And if you take the condition for bright fringe, the condition for bright fringe is the path difference is equals to n lambda. And the same way for dark fringe is path difference is equals to n plus 1 by 2 lambda. Now, so take the path difference here, 2t equals to 2t plus or minus lambda by 2 is equals to n lambda, then 2t is equals to n lambda plus or minus lambda by 2, and we can have 2t equals to n plus or minus 1 by 2 of lambda. So this is the condition for bright fringe under Newton's rings. And now coming here, the path difference is equals to 2t plus or minus lambda by 2 is equals to n lambda plus or minus, sorry, n lambda plus lambda by 2. And if you take this plus or minus lambda by 2 that side, then you can have 2t is equals to n lambda plus lambda by 2 plus or minus lambda by 2. Suppose if you take this one, lambda by 2 plus lambda by 2, or lambda by 2 minus lambda by 2, so it will become 0, then you can have n lambda. And suppose if it is lambda by 2 plus lambda by 2, again it will give you a lambda, which is an integer. Again, if you add this one to this one, you can have n lambda only. Suppose if n is 1, 1 lambda plus lambda will give you 2 lambda. Already the value of 2 is there for n values. So simply we can write 2t is equals to n lambda. So these are the two conditions for dark fringe, and this is the condition for bright fringe. So now in the next step, what we are going to find out is what is the value of t, and substituting value of t, one can have the diameters. Since we can see the rings through the telescope, and one can calculate the diameter of the rings with the help of vernier scales. So the condition for bright fringe is 2t equals to n plus or minus 1 by 2 lambda, and for dark fringe is 2t equals to n lambda. So where t is the thickness of the AFL here. Since it is a varying thickness, at center it is 0, if you keep on moving from center to end part of the plane of convex lens, the thickness of AFL is keep on increasing. So now to calculate the value of t, take a plano convex lens on a plate P and extend the surface of plano convex lens, then you can have the radius of curvature of this plano convex lens, let us say capital R. And now at certain thickness, at certain height, or at certain thickness t, take a ring of radius, take a ring M and N of radius small r. So at center, already we discussed, at center we are having a dark fringe, and then you can have bright, dark, bright, dark, bright. And now take some ring here at this position at a height t, take some ring that may be bright or dark, take some ring of radius small r. And now let us call this interacting point as Q, since the value of QO is t and the value of O dash is 2R. Since from center to here the radius of curvature is capital R, from here to here it's capital R, the total value of O dash is 2R, and the value of QO is small t. Then the value of QO dash will become 2R minus t. From the symmetry, or the from the law of circles, we can have, from the geometry of circles, one can write QM into QN is equals to QO into QO dash. Nothing but the products of the chords are equal, like NQ into QN is equals to QO into QO dash. Since they are not equal, but their products are equal, one has to remember that. And now the value of MQ and QN, since MN is a ring, their radius also equal, so the value of QN is R and MQ is also R. So one can write R into R, that's equals to the value of QO. The value of QO is T into the QO dash is 2R minus T. Then if you multiply, then you can have R square equals to 2RT minus T square. Since T is the thickness, which is very thin, or it's a thin film, so if you square that thickness T, you can have very small value. So one can neglect the value of T square. Then you can have R square equals to 2R into T, that implies T equals to R square by 2 capital R, where small r is the radius of the ring, that may be bright ring or dark ring, and capital E is the radius, capital R is the radius of curvature, and T is the thickness of that particular ring. So now take the value of T and substitute the conditions in bright and dark conditions. So substituting, take the condition for bright fringe 2T equals to N plus R minus 1 by 2 lambda, and substitute the value of T, R square by 2R, in this condition. Since R is the radius of a particular ring, suppose if it is 4th ring, 4th ring radius, 4th bright ring, 4th bright ring radius, 6th dark ring radius. So now take the value and substitute in this condition, T equals to R n square, since n stands for that particular ring number, and R n square by 2R equals to n plus R minus 1 by 2 lambda. And if you solve this one, R n square and everything get cancelled, 2 get cancelled, R n square by R equals to 2 n plus R minus lambda by 2, and R n square equals to 2 n plus R minus 1 lambda R by 2, and finally you can have d n square equals to 2 of 2 n plus R minus 1 lambda by lambda R, and that implies d n equals to 2 of 2 n plus R minus 1 of lambda R, since this is the diameter expression for bright ring. Why we are so concerned about diameter means we can see literally through the telescope, which is kept on the top of the glass plate. And finally, if you take the condition for dark ring 2T equals to n lambda, and by substituting the value of T in this particular one, Rn square equals to 2R, since Rn is the diameter, radius of that particular dark ring. And one can write that Rn, diameter Rn square, we know that diameter equals to 2 of the radius, and then R equals to D by 2. If Rn is a particular ring radius, then Dn will become its diameter. Then Rn square is equals to n lambda r. Finally, you can have Dn square equals to 4 n lambda r. So by using the expressions, one can calculate the diameter of bright rings and dark rings. And next, if you take D4, so that means diameter of 4th dark ring. The expression for dark ring is dn equals to 2 under root n lambda r, and if it is for 4th ring, n value is 4. So 4 lambda r, then you can have 4 under root lambda r, and for D1, first dark ring, it will be 2 under root lambda r. D4 minus D1 will give you 2 of under root lambda r. Similarly, if you calculate for 16th dark ring and 9th dark ring, then also you can have D16 minus D9 as 2 root lambda r. So if you particularly observe these two expressions, in between 1st and 4th ring, the value is 2 root under lambda r. In between 9th and 16th ring also, the value is 2 root lambda r. So if you keep on moving from center to end part of the rings, at the center we are having within a gap of 4 to 1. Suppose 4 to 1, you have the value is 2 root lambda only. The gap between 4th dark ring and 1st dark ring is 2 root lambda r. And that means there is a span of 3 rings only. But if you consider 9 and 16, there is around 7 rings. Even at 7 rings also spaced in a gap of 2 root lambda r. Here, the 3 rings are spaced in a gap of 2 root lambda r. That means if you keep on moving from center to end part of this one, the closeness will be decreased. The distance between 2 rings will be decreased. Initially, if you observe that one, this, the gap between the 2 rings is very less. If we keep on very it's high, and if we keep on moving, the gap between the two will become closer to each other. So this is about why the rings are closely spaced if we keep on moving from center to end part. So this is the reason. Within a gap of two rings also you have the same value, with three rings also you have the same value, within a gap of seven rings also you have the same value. So this is about Newton's rings. And next step, what we are going to see is, how can we find out the radius of curvature? If you don't know R, how can we calculate? And if you don't know lambda, how can we calculate? And if you don't know mu, a refractive index of an unknown liquid, how can we calculate? We can see in the next step. As we already calculated the diameter of dark ring, dn square equals to 4 n lambda r, for a particular ring number n, and for a particular ring number m, dm square can be written as 4 m lambda r. So now dm square minus dn square will give you 4 lambda r of m minus n. And by, if we want to know the unknown radius of curvature of a given plane of convex lens, then take a known lambda value of a monochromatic source of light whose wavelength is around, if it is sodium vapor lamp, it is 5893 angstrom units. Like that, take the known value of lambda, then we can find out the R of unknown value. Suppose if you want to know the unknown value of wavelength or lambda of a given monochromatic source of light, then take a known plano convex lens of radius of curvature R, and with the help of telescope, one can find out the diameter of mth ring and nth dark rings. So by using these two expressions, one can calculate the radius of curvature of lenses and wavelength of unknown sources. And also we can calculate the refractive index of unknown liquids. How can we calculate? Let's see. Since the air film is, since the thin film is occupied by air previously, suppose if I want to calculate the refractive index of an unknown liquid, fill the air column or the thin film with that liquid of refractive index mu. So first do the experiment as like previously, then without this liquid, then you can have a dn square minus dm square minus dn square equals to 4 m minus n of lambda. Now keep the liquid and do the experiment. What the thing that we can found is, without liquid, if you get the rings diameters like this, by keeping the liquid in the film part, thin film part, the diameter of the rings will decrease by an amount of mu. Decrease, the size or the diameter of rings will decrease. So if it decrease, initially without liquid, if it is dn square equals to 4 n lambda r, with the liquid it will become dn dash square equals to 4 n lambda r by mu, where mu is the refractive index of this one. And now for a particular m ring, dm dash square is equals to 4 m lambda r by mu. So since the diameters are decreasing, and dm dash square minus dn dash square equals to 4 m minus n lambda r by mu, since 4 m minus n lambda r is nothing but dm square minus dn square, and substitute here, then you can have this expression. From this one can calculate mu equals to dm dash square minus dn dash square by dm square minus dn square. So with the help of this equation, one can find out the refractive index of unknown liquids. And one has to remember, in reflected case only this is. In reflected case, the central part is dark. And in refracted case, if you see the Newton's rings from the bottom of the glass plate P, then you can have a bright fringe. And now, the color of bright also depends on the type of monochromatic source of light that we are using. If we are using a yellow color source, then the bright will be yellow color. So then the pattern will be like this, dark, yellow, dark, yellow. Of decreasing, all the rings will come closer if you move from center to far away. So this is about Newton's rings.